There is no one definition for a pandemic. The World Health Organization scrapped its criteria 10 years ago after the H1N1 outbreak. Now, it's more subjective. The WHO says it's when a new disease spreads easily from person to person around the world. Now, in more than 50 countries, about a quarter of all nations, coronavirus or COVID-19 is certainly global and can spread from person to person, with more than 82,000 infections in less than 2 months. Yet, the WHO says it still doesn't meet the standard for a pandemic.
Our message continues to be that this virus has pandemic potential. No country should assume it won't get cases. That could be a fatal mistake, and quite literally. This virus does not respect borders.
The WHO says countries should be in a phase of preparedness for a possible pandemic. If one was declared, governments would have to roll out a full-scale response, with mobilisation down to local level and distribution of personal protective equipment, antivirals and other medical supplies. It's costly, and in 2009, the last time the WHO declared a pandemic, some countries criticised the move for burdening them unnecessarily.
WHO and others don't like to use the word pandemic, but by the classical definition, we're really teetering very, very close to that, because there are a number of countries outside of China that do have considerable number of cases.
The costs of a moderate to severe pandemic are high. The World Bank puts it at nearly $570 billion. Even without meeting the threshold, coronavirus has shaken financial markets. But the human cost is still low relative to past pandemics. The 1918 Spanish flu killed 50 million people and infected one-third of the world's population. The most recent pandemic, swine flu in 2009, killed up to 575,000 people. Coronavirus sits at 0.5% of that, with the WHO hoping it levels off and it doesn't have to declare a pandemic. Charlotte Ballas, Al Jazeera.